ابن مسعود نوير إن حديث أحمد في مسنده رحمه الله تعالى خط لنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خطا ثم قال هذا سبيل الله، ثم خط خطوطا عن يمينه وشماله قال هذه سبل على رأس كل منها شيطان يدعو إليه، ثم تلا قوله تعالى وأن هذا صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوه ولا تتبعوا السبل فتفرق بكم عن سبيله. ابن مسعود said the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم drew a line for us on the ground in the dirt. And he said, this is the straight path of Allah. This is the path of Allah. Then he drew on the sides, right? SubhanAllah, amazing, amazing narrations. But people don't understand. He drew lines on the right and lines on the left. He said, these are other paths. On the head of each one is the shaitan calling you to himself or to this way. Then he recited the ayah in the Quran and that Allah said, and this is my path. This is my straight path. So follow it. And do not follow other paths which will lead you, mislead you from the path of Allah. You see this beautiful hadith? He told him, this is the path of Allah. This is the sunnah. This is what I'm living. My way. And there are other ways. Shayateen are calling you to them. So every Sufi is a shaitan calling to Sufism. And every Ash'ari, and every Mu'tazili, and every Shi'i, all of these people are shayateen from the ins calling to their way. Wallahi al-azim. Wallahi. If they're ignorant, Allah will deal with them on the Day of Judgment. We judge by the outwardly and the apparent. These are, according to the Nas of the Prophet ﷺ, shayateen calling you to them. The Sunnah is one. The Sunnah is one. The way is one. Anything other than that is a shaitan. And if you follow the shayateen, do you go to Jannah? Do you put your hand with the shaitan, hand in hand, and go to Jannah? La wallah. He's going to the Jahannam, and so will be his followers. Among the mushrikeen and the mubtadi'een. Illa ma sha Allah. Let's say someone is still stubborn. Do you think we need to refer to the Sahaba to see how they understood these narrations in these ayat? We did. Let me give you in brief the story of Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. It's in Sunan al-Darimi, the hadith of Yahya ibn Salama, and it's in others as well. Abu Mas'ud radiallahu anhu was at home. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari went to the house of Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. He saw some of his students waiting outside. He said, is Ibn Mas'ud inside? Did he come out yet? He said, he has not come out yet. So when he came out, he said, Ya Abu Abdurrahman, this was his kunya, I have seen something in the masjid, which I rejected internally. But I didn't see anything but good. I rejected it internally, but I saw nothing but good. He said, what did you see? He told him, if you live long, you will see it. And he took him to the masjid. Now pay attention now. They went to the masjid. What did they find? They found some people sitting down in halaqat, circles, and they had pebbles, small rocks. And one was the leader of the halaqa. He would say to them, kabbiru mi'a. Say Allahu Akbar 100 times. So they would all carry the pebbles and count. Does that remind you of something? The sabha, the bid'ah. Kabbiru mi'a, they will do 100, Allahu Akbar. Sabbihu mi'a, 100, subhanallah. Did Ibn Mas'ud say, mashallah, majlis dhikr, a place of remembering Allah, let me sit with them, let me benefit from them? He said, what are you doing? مَا أَسْرَعَ هَلَكَتُكُمْ يَا أُمَّةُ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمُ. How quickly you have destroyed yourself, O Ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Verily the clothes of the Messenger of Allah have not worn out yet, and his plates are not broken yet. Either you are better guided than the Messenger of Allah, or you are opening a door of misguidance. He said in another narration, he said, Ana ibn Mas'ud. I am Ibn Mas'ud. I am the Sahabi of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, oh Abu Abdurrahman, we only intended good. Oh, we have good intention. We just want to remember Allah. He said, Kam min muridin lil khayri la yablugho. How often does someone intend good, but he will never acquire it. He will never get it. So what does that tell you? Now these are the same people, by the way, who wind up fighting against the Muslims. These were the same Khawarij. They were sitting in the masjid, remembering Allah. How? In a manner according to the Sunnah? Did the Messenger of Allah sit in the masjid with the Sahaba in a circle and say Allahu Akbar 100 times? No. Now even though the act of worship of ibadah, this is called bid'ah idafiyah, it's relevant. They try to add it to Islam. based on another existing act of worship. Once they tried to remember Allah in this manner, Ibn Mas'ud rejected that. He said, you will be destroyed. You are opening a door of misguidance. He did not like that. And Abu Musa radiallahu anhu had the same feeling. He said, I saw good, meaning they were remembering Allah, but I denied it in my heart. I rejected it in my heart. It wasn't good. Because they were in remembering Allah. Does that remind you of the Sufis? Does that remind you of these people? They do the same thing. Ibn Mas'ud didn't think it was okay. So we don't think it's okay. The Sahaba didn't think it was okay. We don't think it's okay. Even if you're remembering Allah, even if you are remembering Allah. Hey. Ibn Mas'ud said, radiallahu anhu, اتبعوا ولا تبتدعوا فقد كفيتم. Follow and do not invent. You have been given sufficient. You have been sufficed. He is teaching us. Follow, don't invent. Hadhaif ibn al-Yaman said, do not do any act of worship which the Sahaba didn't do. Let's give it to you easy. Don't do anything the Sahaba didn't do. Ibn Umar said, كُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَ وَإِنْ رَآهَا النَّاسُ حَسَنًا. Allahu Akbar. Every innovation is misguidance, even if the people see it as good. So Allah gave him this. This is you know, Allah's blessings of the fiqh, the understanding of the Sahaba. For them to say something that we direly need today. We need this very bad. For someone to hear a Sahabi saying, every innovation is misguidance, even if the people perceive it as something good. This is their understanding. Don't be making no distinction. Good bid'ah, bad bid'ah. Mu'adh ibn Jabal said, إِيَّاكُمْ فَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمَا يُبْتَدَعْ فَإِنَّا مَبْتُدِعَ الضَّلَالَ. These are among the senior scholars of the Sahaba. He said, woe to you from that which is invented and innovated, because everything they have innovated is misguidance. So I warn the innovators. You see me? If you have been worshipping Allah, inshallah everyone here upon the sunnah, if you have been worshipping Allah in a manner not according to the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, listen to this. The hadith in Tirmidhi sahih. إِنَّ اللَّهَ احْتَجَزَ التَّوْبَةَ عَنْ صَاحِبِ كُلِّ بِدْعَ حَتَّى يَدْعَ بِدْعَتَهُ. Allah will not give him the ability to have tawbah. The Prophet ﷺ said, Allah has restricted tawbah from every innovator until he abandons his innovation. You keep doing bid'ah and Allah will not give you tawbah. And if you die without tawbah, you know where you're going. Second warning. لِيَحْمِلُوا أَوْزَارَهُمْ كَامِلًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَمِنْ أَوْزَارِ الَّذِينَ يُضِلُّونَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Every innovator will carry his sins and the sins of all those who follow them without knowledge on the day of judgment. Everyone who follows your bid'ah, Hamza Yusuf and the rest of the clan, everyone who among the Muslims who is fascinated with you and your innovations, all of them you will have to meet Allah Azza wa Jal with on the day of judgment. And what will you do? What will you do? Every innovator, what will you do? You'll be in trouble. Thirdly, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the hadith of the Hawd, his fount, where the righteous people upon the sunnah will drink from his hand sallallahu alaihi wasallam water, after which they will never be thirsty again. When some of the people of bid'ah will come, and the angels will prevent them, he will say, my companions, my ummah, they will say, إِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي مَا أَحْدَثُ بَعْدَكَ. He says, you don't know what they invented into the deen after you. He will say, suhqan, suhqan, may Allah destroy them, may Allah destroy them. On the day of judgment, the Messenger of Allah has nothing to do with you. You either act upon the sunnah or you are misguided. There's no third choice for anyone. Fourthly, they are cursed by Allah, the malaika, and everyone. The Prophet ﷺ said, من أحدث فيها أي في المدينة أو آوى محدثا هو المبتدع فعليه لعنة الله والملائكة والناس أجمعين. Whoever introduces anything in Medina speaking, or he provides protection, he gives shelter to an innovator, upon him is the curse of Allah, the angels, and all of mankind. The scholars agree that the mubtadi does not have a shahada, no testimony. If he were to go to court and say, I saw this person kill that person, they'll say, get out of here, man. We don't hear from people from you. According to all the madahib, all the ulama, ijma', consensus, that the mubtadi', his shahada is worthless. What did he leave for himself? Allah has angels, the people curse him. He will be prevented from tawbah. He will carry the sins of everyone on the day of judgment. His testimony is rejected. What did he leave for himself? The Mubtadi'. Why don't they follow the Sunnah? Allah al-Musta'an. Listen, we're almost done. Let me give you the criteria. Some may say, okay, akhi, I want to do that. I'm afraid of bid'ah now. You've done the job, inshallah. I don't ever want to do bid'ah. You scared me. I want to leave bid'ah. How do I know what's a sunnah, what's a bid'ah? Look, very easy. Everything the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did or approved or spoke about is a sunnah. Everything he left alone, which he could have done, is a bid'ah. Clear? Let me give you a couple of ayat which should put an end to this. Allah says in the Quran, اتبعوا ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم ولا تتبعوا من دونه أولياء قليلا ما تذكرون. Follow what was sent down to you from your Lord, and do not follow other allies, other friends, other protectors besides Allah. Little do you remember. Follow what Allah revealed. Don't go anywhere else. فلا وربك لا يؤمنون حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت ويسلموا تسليما. Nay, by your Lord, they shall not believe until they make you a judge concerning everything they dispute about. Then they find no discomfort in their heart concerning what you judge, and they submit in full submission. Once you accept the Sunnah blindly, then and only then you have Iman. Once you want to put your mind into it, then you don't have perfect Iman. Allah says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ نُقَيِّدْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَيَصُدُّونَهُمْ عَنِ السَّبِيلِ وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Whosoever turns away from the remembrance of the Most Merciful, the Quran and the Sunnah, we will assign for him a devil, and he will be his close companion. Then Allah says, وَإِنَّهُمْ, and verily, without a doubt, they will be misleading them from the path while they think that they are rightly guided. And this is the condition of every innovator today. He does not think he's wrong. He thinks he's dead right and you dead wrong. He thinks he's upon the Sunnah and wallahi he's upon the bid'ah. But just as Allah said, when they turn away from the Quran and the Sunnah and the understanding of the Salaf, the consequence is that Allah will give him a shaitan, he will lead him astray, and they think that they're going straight to Jannah. Subhanallah al-Azim. وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Whosoever opposes the messenger after the truth and the guidance has become clear and manifest and follows a path other than that of the believers, we will allow him to take that path, then we will make him enter Jahannam, and what an evil abode. If you oppose the messenger after the sunnah became clear to you and you follow other than the way of the sahaba, who were the mu'mineen when this ayah was revealed? The sahaba. If you follow other their way, Allah will let you take that way, but Allah will take you to Jahannam eventually. And the ayat are many, but I don't want to take any longer. The idea, my brothers and sisters in Islam, the Muslim ummah is suffering a lot from innovators and innovations. And until we clean this deen up from these people and their practices, and our intent and hope from Allah is that the practices will be cleansed and the people will become among the sunnah. Now, we don't want to lose any Muslim. We wish good for every Muslim. We hate the bid'ah, but we wish good for every Muslim, even if he's falling into bid'ah. We want him to leave the bid'ah, otherwise we wouldn't give him da'wah. But until we do so, the ummah will not be sound. The ummah will not be the honor. The reign of the Islamic ummah will not be acquired until we clean our deen and we raise the generation upon the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it's an obligation on every one of us to learn the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah and to know what innovations are and to warn against them and to act as propagators against the bid'ah and for the sunnah. If every one of us played his role, then we can make a major difference in the community. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.